Hello everyone, welcome back after a long time. Actually, I got some request how to plot the graph to find the focal length of the convex lens by using displacement method. That video already I have uploaded. Today I am going to make a video on the topic how to plot the graph to find the focal length of the convex lens. Actually, this process is applicable for all experiment. You can apply it. So let's start the video. Now, after doing this experiment, I got that values which I have written in that table. You can copy it, okay, or you can take a screenshot of it. That values I have found by doing this experiment, the displacement method, okay. Now separately I have written the values for x and y which I am going to put on that graph. But what is the process? So let's start. See, over here I have taken one graph. In your board practical, that 2 millimeter graph will be given. So in that graph you have to plot the values. See, here this is the divisions, but in the table which you have got, that is the values, okay. Now first you draw y-axis and x-axis. Now check what is the maximum values you got in the x-axis. See, over here in the x-axis the highest values is 89, and in y-axis the highest value is 125.03. that I have to plot in the graph. Now along x-axis the maximum value we got, that is 89 or 90 approximately, and along y-axis 125.03 or 125 approximately. Now remember this, at least 80 to 90% portion of the graph you have to use. That's why I have taken 10 division equals to 10 unit. 10 division means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 division equals to 10 unit. If I take 10 division equals to 10 unit, then I can put all the values within 90% portion. That's why I have taken 10 division equals to 10 unit. And next 10 division will be 20, because this difference should be equal. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. In the same way, along y-axis, 125 we have to put. So maximum value is 125. So at least 80 to 90% portion or 80% portion you have to cover. That's why I have taken over here 10 division. 10 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 division equals to 20. Next 10 division will be how much? 40, because the difference should be equal. See, this difference is 20. So this difference is also 20. Along x-axis, this difference 10. This difference also 10. Understood? So 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140. 140 is not needed, but actually the highest value is 125. That's why I have taken this 140. Now start how to put the values in that graph. See, at first what you have to do, you have to write this one at the top of the graph, which is one smallest division along x-axis. How to find out? See, along x-axis as I am calculating, so 10 division equals to 10 I have taken. So 10 division equals to 10. 10 division equals to 10 unit. So 1 division equals to how much? 10 by 10 means 1. So one smallest division along x-axis, which is 1 unit. Okay. Now in the same way, one smallest division along y-axis. How much? See, 10 division we have taken 20. So 1 division how much? 10 division equals to 20. Okay. So 1 division equals to how much? 20 by 10 means how much? 2. 10 division equals to 20 means 1 division equals to how much? 1 division equals to 2. So that's why I'm writing over here one smallest division along y-axis, which is 2, and along one smallest division along x-axis, which is 1. One smallest division means this one. This is 1. Okay. And along y-axis, this is 1. So that I'm calculating. Now see in the table, the coordinate of the first point is 69.1 and 98.63. Actually, these are the values. These are the values. And we are going to convert the values into division. How to convert the values into division? See, one smallest division along x-axis we got 1 unit, and one smallest division along y-axis we got, that is 2 unit. Okay. So along x-axis I am going to put 69.1, approximately we can take 69.1 divided by 1. To convert the values into division, 69.1 divided by 1 smallest division along x-axis, as I am taking the value along the x-axis. This is for the x-axis table, and this is for these are for the y-axis table. Okay, so 69.1 divided by 1 means 69, approximately 69. So 69 I am putting over here. Look, this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, this is 65. 69 means this point, 69, only x-axis. Now I have to put the value of y-axis. See, along the y-axis the value is given 98.63. So 98.63 is the value. We have to convert into division. How? 98.63 divided by 1 smallest division along y-axis divided by 2. So that is coming how much? That is coming 49.13, or approximately we can take 49. Okay. So along y-axis 49 we have to put. See, along x-axis we got 69 and along y-axis we got 49. So this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 49 over here. So this is the point whose coordinate will be, don't write 69 over here. This coordinate will be from the table that we got 69, obviously, because we have divided by 1, that's why we are getting 69.1 or 69. And the y coordinate will be, don't write 100, because this is 100, so over here that will be how much? 98.63. Understood? 98.63. The values which has given in the table, that value over here you will write as the coordinate. In the same way, second point is given along x-axis. You check it, you can check it. 74.1. So 74 I can take, 70 here it is 70, so 74. Okay, and along y-axis 105.07. That how to put? 105, do it, 105 divided by 105.07 divided by 2. So once that value divided by one smallest division along y-axis. Okay, so that is coming 52.5. This is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 52.5 means 53. So here I am taking the point. And whose coordinate will be how much? 74 and 105. See, here I am getting 53. 53 is the division. Don't write the division over here. You will write over here the values, means the coordinate, 74 and 105 point something. So that, this is how you have to put. In the third figure, in the third data is given 79. 79 means here 79, because 70 over here 79. And the along y-axis the coordinate is given 110.39. So again you divide it, 110.39 divided by 2. So that is coming 55.1. So 55.1, see, this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 55, 55 in this is 55.1, so 55 you can take this one. Okay, I'm not writing the coordinate over here. Next, fourth point is 84, so 84 over here, 84, and along the 84, the y coordinate is given 117.04 divided by 2, so that is 58. So 58, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, sorry, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 58 over here. And x coordinate was 84, mean this is. Understood the process? Okay, and the last point is 89 mean this one is 89 and 125.03, so 125.03 divided by 2, which is coming 62. So 10 20 30 40 50 60 62 over here. Okay, see, actually these points are coming in a single straight line, so we can draw the straight line over here. Here you see I have drawn the straight line, and this straight line is passing through these all points. And now how to find the slope? Slope, any two point out of these five, any two points you can take. And see, suppose these two points I am taking whose coordinate is given. Coordinate means you will write from the table. So here coordinate is given 69 and 98, and here 74 and 105. Okay, so these two points I am taking, and how to find the slope? Slope is equals to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay, so y2 means which one? Suppose this is the first point and this is second point. So x1, y1, x2, y2. So y2 means 105 minus 98 divided by that point I am not taking, divided by x2. x2 means 74 minus 69. That you calculate. After calculation, that value is coming 1.4. Okay. And the formula for finding the focal length that you know equals to 10 into S. So 10 into S means 10 into 1.4, which is coming 14 centimeter. Okay. This is the process how to find the focal length of the convex lens by using displacement method. Now here you can ask, why I am dividing these values divided by one smallest division along y axis, and here along x axis one smallest division I am dividing it. Why? The answer is, see, why I am dividing? Because this is the value we have to convert into division to plot the graph. Now here I got already one smallest division along x axis how much? 1 unit, and one smallest division along y-axis how much? 2 unit. Now see, means 2 unit equals to 1 smallest division. Okay, suppose along y-axis I am calculating. So 1 means this is 1 by 2. This is the actually values. This is the value. 1 smallest division along y-axis, it is 2, that is the value. So value equals to 1 division. 1 equals to 1 by 2 division. So 98.63, that value equals to how much division? So 98.63 divided by 2. That will come in division. Understood? So again I am taking. See, here 2 value means 1 division. 2, when the value is 2, then the division is 1. When the value is 1, then the division is 1 by 2. When the value is 98.63, the division is 98.60 divided by 2. In the same way, along x axis, when the value is 1, the division is 1. When the value is 69.1, the value is how much? 69.1, because divided by 1 means that same value will come. Divided by 1 means 69.1. Understood? So this is the process how to plot the graph. So I hope you have understood. If you didn't understand, please give a comment. Okay? Bye.